Welcome back to the channel, guys. Let's have a little look at the CPI data just in from the US, plus a load of altcoin updates as well. If that sounds good to you, make sure you subscribe to the channel and check out the pinned comment down below. We're going to hop straight on in here, as this has pretty much dropped within the last 20 odd minutes here. So this is from Alex Kruger, an economist, trader, and sharing his views, as it says in his bio. That was it. That was the peak for inflation. It's now behind us. Inflation has topped out. So his prediction was that US inflation would top on this Friday's CPI, which is consumer price index print. So I think last month it was in the 7% region, and lots of people were expecting a pretty bad turnout today, maybe 7% plus. But however, it is printed a 6.8%. So this is actually a little bit lower than some were projecting. And if we just jump over to Jan's tweets here, these moves based on the CPI data release from the US, Bitcoin green candle here, and the USD, the Dixie here, went straight down. So you can see that money flowed into Bitcoin. If we go down here as well, you can see the S&P 500 had a nice tick up. So this is seemingly showing that the numbers are pretty much on track where people thought we were. This would have already been priced in by the market and basically will mean no acceleration of the taper by the Fed beyond what was already expected. Of course, the Fed do meet next week, and that could also be another period of volatility in the market before we get some clarity on the next steps from them. But this was a potential road bump today, and it seems that Bitcoin has passed it so far. So the print, 6.8% for CPI. Of course, those figures are quite fudged, to be honest with you, but nevertheless, risk on environment may be resuming here for the crypto markets. So Kaleo actually predicted this a few days ago, still expecting one more flush to somewhere in the region of 48.5K for Bitcoin and then run it back turbo. We came a little bit lower than that just yesterday, down to around 47.5, but we got that 48.5K level hit. And then from here, we're up towards around 49.5 as of filming right now. Let's pull up the 1 minute chart for a laugh. And you can see this was pretty much the moment at which 6.8% was confirmed for CPI data, clearly not triggering any algos to start dumping the market, and in fact started to buy, it would seem. So things on the up here, maybe we'll flatten out here around 49K, but all in all, this was not a bad thing. And this was a potential, as I say, speed bump in the road that we've just passed over. So then an update here from Tech Dev on BTC. Bitcoin's been ranging since January. Eventually it will break. And he thinks it's going to be breaking to the upside. Let's just pull this chart out a bit. So this chart shows us back in 2020, we had a long consolidation period and then a big breakout that we all remember. And then this year we've had another long consolidation period, pretty much ranging between 30 and 60K. This is also something Benjamin Cowan's been talking about, that pretty much the year of 2021 has been a consolidation and reaccumulation period for Bitcoin. And thus 2022 will be the next explosive move of parabolic growth and potentially the top for the cycle. If we just go down here, Michael Vanderpop reckons we're going to 250 to 350K. Maybe that is on the uber bullish side for me. I don't think we're maybe going to go that high. And I would certainly be looking to heavily scale out the market at $150,000 per BTC. But some of these traders here are agreeing that we have a big breakout to come still for Bitcoin out of this 60K region and somewhere to the upside from there. So all positive stuff for the medium to long term. Now, in terms of getting mass adoption, can you think of a better way than WhatsApp rolling out crypto payments over in the US? Clearly, that'll be a trial run in the US before a full rollout. But how much more bullish can you get than this? Because clearly, billions of people use WhatsApp. I think the numbers are over 2 billion at this point in time. Most of the people I know, and probably most of the people you know, utilize WhatsApp on a regular basis. So if they can be the gateway into crypto for many new users, we know that everyone is pretty much paying with digital forms of money at this point. Cash is a little bit dead, and we're now just used to pinging money across via our mobiles. Well, why not just utilize WhatsApp? And this would mean that you don't really need to use traditional fintech apps anymore. You can just use your favorite chat app and conduct some money transfers in, say, USDP here, as Novi is backed by Paxos, and that is the USD Paxos stablecoin there. But this just makes it super simple for normal individuals to be brought into the crypto space without having to do very much here. So I think that this is a super bull case for the long-term growth potential of the crypto industry, which of course is inevitable in most of our opinions. Now onto some altcoins here, and Brad Sherman has actually come out with a good bit of banter here. This is his legit Twitter feed, And he put this: mongoose defeats cobra, mongoose defeats hamster-like creature. This tweet is not intended to provide investment advice. Of course, he talked about Mongoose Coin and then someone created it. It looked like it was going down the pan yesterday, but maybe, just maybe, there is some life left in Mongoose Coin here. That does look like a lower high to me though, but rather amusing nonetheless that he's come up with that and then people are still trading the Mongoose Coin on Binance Smart Chain. Now here we have Wonderland, the time token. This one has come down considerably from its highs. Of course, this one gives huge APYs. At the moment, I know Danny has some thoughts about reducing the overall APY and he doesn't want it to be hyperinflationary for too long. It did peak out at around 10K and is down to around 4.4K right now. You can get 79,000% APY on this token. Stake your time and you get Memo in return. This, of course, is a high risk strategy, but rather than aping in when it was at 10K, now it's at 4.4K. Probably a little bit of a better time. I know a lot of people are interested in getting into these rebase tokens like Ohm and Time. So just wanted to cover that quickly, but this was from Danny here. Price on Time has been going down due to some liquidations. Please keep in mind when leveraging your liquidation price or health factor. This avoids giving people free entries and free money as liquidity is very deep. And someone does point out down here that probably most of the people utilizing this right now don't even know what a liquidation is. The users you're attracting don't even know what liquidations are for real. And this is because it's been trending on the likes of YouTube and on TikTok, and people are just aping in because they see a huge rate of return and potentially getting wiped out here. Now over to some Polkadot parachain news. Parallel Finance has won the fourth slot on Polkadot. So this one had over 30,000 contributors and 10.75 million DOT were contributed overall. So thus far we have Moonbeam, Akala, A-Star and Parallel all winners. And we have another round going here before Christmas, December 9th to December 16th. And in the runnings, Clover, Efinity, Manta, LitEntry, SubDAO, SubGame and Ares Protocol. None of these are ones I want to contribute to currently. I'm going to wait till the new year. And potentially I quite like the sound of Centrifuge with the NFTs for real world assets. And also I want to keep a stack back just for later rounds when people maybe don't have any DOT left. And we could get some late runners. Now, Polkadot has been disappointing with the release of these parachains. Of course, the parachains aren't live as of yet, but we were expecting a ton of DOT to be removed from circulating supply, and thus the price on the exchanges would have to go up, but it hasn't really played out like that. So a lot of people have been disappointed with this. If you look at the 180-day chart, we're back to prices that we saw around the start of October. So pretty deflating in terms of people getting involved with this one, trying to trade it for a big return with the parachain rollouts. Maybe we'll still see some bullish momentum to come again, but at this moment in time, it looks like it's been a little bit of a flop on the price side. But focusing on the tech, we're waiting for these parachains to go live and see how that interoperable layer zero architecture actually works out. So this from the Luna ecosystem. So someone posted this: Lunatics, as of now, the top 10 validators by voting power have a total of 43% of voting power between them all. So this is not decentralized by any means, and not saying they would come together to control votes, but they could do, which is an issue. As you can see, the stats, Orion Money, Staking, BeeHarvest, 8, 7, 6% respectively. And what I like to see here was Doe pretty much getting involved straight away to suggest this: I propose to eliminate anchor airdrops to delegators of the top 10 validators. So if you've selected any of these guys as a validator, he's proposing that you will no longer get anchor airdrops. And a lot of people have delegated for that specific reason. They are bullish on anchor, and rightly so. So the proposal will go live tomorrow. That'll be Saturday. Prepare accordingly and re-delegate. So if you go over to the staking tab here and you are actually delegating to one of these top 10s, for me, I've actually got some coins with Orion, so I will switch these up and ensure a better balance of power. All you would have to do, say we're going to choose Talis, for example, click on Talis. You don't need to undelegate from, say, Orion, but rather just come here and redelegate. If you go through an undelegation process, you have to wait 21 days. That means 3 weeks, you not getting any rewards. If you redelegate, it will just happen immediately. So that is the way to do it. Luna price ticking up once again here, 71 bucks. Now let's pull out the 30-day chart here. We can see higher low, higher low, higher low, higher low again. And with that bullish CPI print, maybe we're going to see a bit of strength in the altcoins here. Not that Luna needs much help, but that 77 buck all-time high firmly within sights again. In terms of the BTC price though, draw your attention over to that. Let's pull that chart out. Going from 70,000 sats per Luna to up to 150,000 sats in a period of just a couple of weeks is one hell of a growth rate. And one way, even if you are a full Bitcoin maxi, of just stacking more Bitcoin to play some of these super bullish altcoins. Luna, certainly one of those. Then yesterday we had ZK Day for Polygon Network, which was a very interesting one to watch. About 3.5 hours I spent going through it. Very technical language used throughout, so it will be over most people's heads. However, it was informative nonetheless. So the big drop, the big announcement they came out with was Polygon Zero, which relates to this. Polygon welcomes Mir Protocol, a groundbreaking ZK startup, in a $400 million deal. These guys have a lot of money due to the increase in token price over the last 12 months, from literally a couple of cents to now $2 plus. Mir's amazing team developed the world's fastest ZK scaling tech, and we are joining hands to utilize it and build Polygon Zero. So a bit of a merger acquisition here, and Polygon firmly putting itself in the driving seat for this ZK narrative. I think exposure to Polygon for that narrative is a must. And one of the team here, Brendan, was showcasing some information and a new upgrade called Plonky 2, which is a crazy name. And within this, he suggests a 100x speed up for ETH utilizing the layer 2 here of Polygon Zero. So some crazy, crazy stuff. Vitalik was also on the stream as well, and he did confirm that the kind of end state for Ethereum would be the users migrating to L2s, and we will have a very much multi-chain future, but utilizing Ethereum as the settlement layer and tapping into its security model. So that was very, very interesting, and it also makes you super bullish on these layer 2 solutions. And if you just imagine a wide web around Ethereum, the main chain, with all these layer 2s becoming interoperable over time, having hugely scalable blockchains utilizing zero knowledge proofs and various other techniques here. There's also a privacy focus from Polygon Nightfall, another interesting part of that presentation. Well, this will mean a hugely scalable L2 architecture that can settle back on the L1, and we can utilize essentially Ethereum EVM compatible chains with huge throughputs and a low cost. So super, super bullish on Polygon. This one ticking up nicely again. All-time high 262, we're at 226. This will break all-time highs very soon, as long as Bitcoin can show some form of bullishness, or at least not gonna continue dumping. And then this one as well, Hermes Network that I got into, does not care about the Bitcoin dump. It's literally just been pumping throughout here. Let's pull up the 7-day chart. Looks super, super keen to go even higher. Again, Polygon Hermes and this Hermes Network have joined up. So Polygon firmly in the driving seat, and Polygon the token, this Hermes Network token, has as well, definitely wants to have on your radar. Then finally here over on the Ramp DeFi application, you are being paid to borrow RUSD stablecoins. You deposit any of these tokens, take out an RUSD loan against that collateral. You'll still earn on your collateral here, but when you borrow RUSD against it, there is a 5% fee, but they're going to pay you 30% in Ramp tokens. So this fee will be in dollars, and this payment will be in Ramp. But on the Ramp token itself, that is a positive 25% that you're going to get for borrowing money. Now, don't go and leave yourself up too much. Be aware of liquidation prices, but this is definitely an opportunity in the market right now. And a little bit more on this, the RUSD borrowing program. So 30 million Ramp are allocated for RUSD borrowing taking place on Binance Smart Chain. So they have various incentive pools running over different time periods. For the first month, 3 million Ramp will be allocated. In months 2 to 4, 2.25 million, 1.5 in months 5 to 12, and then through months 13 to 23. So the second year of these, 750,000 Ramp per month will be rewarded. So there is a vesting schedule with this. So you'll see that there's like a claim slash vesting tab that shows how many Ramp you've earned so far. And users can either choose to claim all the rewards on the spot, and that will get a 50% penalty. So if you've got 500 in rewards, you can get them all now, but you only get 250. Or you can press the vest button. You'll receive 25% immediately and 25% after the following durations, 30, 60, and 90 days. So do be aware of that. But overall, an awesome platform there on Ramp DeFi. Go and check it out. Done loads of videos on it and still bullish on that one for the future. So there we have it. We covered the CPI data and how that's affecting Bitcoin and the wider markets right now. Plus, we've gone through a load of different altcoins, some of them more bullish than others. but definitely some key sectors to look at. ZK Rollups, Polygon, Hermes Network, and of course Luna as well. These three tokens seemingly want to push higher and higher. Not financial advice, but do check them out. And I will see you guys after the weekend. Have a good one and goodbye.